Good evening to one and all. I welcome you all on behalf of the Unique Academy. Today, as a part of this webinar, we'll be discussing about how we can prepare economics as an optional. What should be the strategy? What study materials we need to follow? How to make notes? What should be the writing style? What and how we need to focus on contemporary issues. So largely, as a part of this webinar, I'll be focusing upon all these components. As in the previous webinar for this particular subject, I have already discussed with you about syllabus. I have already discussed you about economics as a subject. I have already discussed you about what books and study materials we need to follow. So largely in this webinar today, I'll be emphasizing upon how to read economics, how to read books and magazines, how to read contemporary issues related to economics. Most of times we know study material, we do have study material, we know there are large number of books available, but what to select, how to select, how many books we need to refer for different topics as far as this subject is concerned, what should be the strategy for contemporary issues. So there are different questions which strikes a student who wants to select economics as an optional. So largely, today the overall presentation will be focusing upon these 5 to 6 points, though it seems very simple. But here, most of the students do not follow the right track and they are not able to complete the syllabus in well-defined time period. How in less time span we can cover the syllabus in holistic way? So as far as holistic perspective of this particular subject is concerned, we need to know how we can read, how we can refer, what to read, what to refer, what is the importance of understanding economic concepts, to what extent we can use mathematics and statistics in economics. What is the relevance of econometrics as far as optional subject is concerned? And if we are able to understand a particular concept, how we can analyze this particular concept? How we can analyze economic variable? And if we can analyze how to interpret interpretations of the data is very, very important. Interpretations of the findings are very, very important as far as economics is concerned. How we can correlate the economic theories with the contemporary issues which are taking place? What is the relevance of current events as far as this subject is concerned? And last one we'll be focusing upon notes and answers writing. So 50% of the overall discussion definitely will be one way where I'll be sharing with you my experience as far as these components are concerned. And last part, I'll be interacting with you with your specific and individual queries as far as opting economics as an optional subject is concerned. So before I tell you whether you should opt a particular optional subject or not, you need to list down a set of subjects which you are familiar with, which you consider to be interesting to you, in which you do have interests, in which you do have certain background, and in which you can play with the concepts related with that particular subject. To try to list down 2 to 3 subjects, and when you list down those 3 subjects, 2 to 3 subjects, you need to go through the overall syllabus of those particular subjects also. There are certain precautions which you need to take while selecting optional. And those precautions are, you often go to a particular teacher or a student and you start asking that, sir, which subject you should opt? And to my surprise, you are meeting that teacher for the first time. And though that teacher tries to do justice as far as suggestions is concerned, but remember, that teacher, that mentor of yours, if he knows your strength and weakness, then that's fine. But then, if he does not know your strength and weakness, and if he is suggesting a subject with which he is comfortable to you, I am telling you, this is a blunder. There are 2 things which you need to focus upon. You only ask the concerned person who have certain knowledge about but that particular subject which you are going to opt as an optional. If being an economics teacher, if you ask me that whether you should opt geography or not, and if I start suggesting you, I am playing with your career because I do not have any geography background. I do not know for the first instance when you come to me for these suggestions. And if I try to convince you by saying that you should go and opt geography or history or any other subject in which I do not have expertise. I am committing a blunder. I am playing with your career. So when you are taking suggestions for the first of all, when you are asking a particular teacher, particularly your mentor, overall informations you can get, but then optional selection should be your final decision. And that decision should be based upon your strength, your weaknesses, opportunities with that particular subject, and you need to assess traits related with that particular subject also, and that's what is considered to be SWOT analysis, SWOT. So whenever you are selecting a subject, assess that subject that on the basis of SWOT analysis, you can do your SWOT analysis also. So there are two subjects, history, geography, or economics or political science. First of all, you start assessing the strength of that particular subject. Strength means how that subject can help you in GS, how that subject can help you in writing good answers, whether that subject can be covered in well-defined time or not, whether you can get enough study material with that particular subject or not, whether you do have any background with that particular subject or not. And that determines the strength of the subject as far as UPSC preparation is concerned. Similarly, weaknesses also. Weakness of a particular subject, I am trying to tell you, what can define weakness of a particular subject if I do not have any background? I do not have any interest. I do not know stat, but this subject has a statistics also. I do not have analytical bent of mind, but this subject requires analytical bent of mind. What are the opportunities if I opt this particular subject? If not UPSC, whether this subject can help me in other sector or not? What lies ahead with this particular subject? And the traits related with a particular subject also, what is the scoring? Whether this subject is scoring or not? If I select this subject, whether considering my strengths and weaknesses, I'll be able to get good score, good marks or not. So overall, when we are trying to select an optional subject, I'm not focusing only upon economics. Let it be any subject which is defined by UPSC. You need to do a thorough SWOT analysis, not only of the subject, but of yourself also. This SWOT analysis cannot be done by a particular teacher unless and until he knows your strengths and weaknesses. If you are in touch with me for the last so many years, and I know your strengths and weaknesses, so I can guide you in a better way. But when you are meeting for the first and second time with a particular person, and you are asking him or her that whether you should opt a particular subject or not, though that subject is not his expertise, but at times people have different thought process about all the subjects in the world, and they start suggesting you, please do not take such suggestions. Take suggestions from the individuals who have expertise in that particular subject. I do not know history. I may not be the right person to suggest to you whether you should opt history or not. I do not know political science. I do not know economics. I, as an individual, should not suggest to you, because neither I know the subject nor I know your strengths and weaknesses also. And that's why it may not be the right to suggest to you. Once, so what I'm trying to tell you, the selection of a particular subject should be done largely by a particular student at this particular level. You are matured enough to decide what suits you and what does not suit you. So, meeting the right person, taking suggestions from the right person, focusing on your interest areas, your strengths and weaknesses, largely will help you in selection or a subject in optional. Once you select, let's see, you are in dilemma about two subjects X and Y. And most of the time, students happen to ask teachers that, sir, X and Y, mera do optional subjects I want to take up, whether I should take X or whether I should take Y. Till that this extent, you can take the help. But I tell you, in these also, you please go through the syllabus of both the subjects. Read twice, thrice. Go through the syllabus, each and every element of the syllabus you need to read carefully. You need to read between the lines also. Few of the topics which are mentioned in the syllabus, you need to explore that also. And after going through the syllabus, if you are convinced and clear that you can do it, think, take time before you finalize the optional. Afterwards, once you are okay with the syllabus, refer previous year's question paper. Try to think about that questions. Try to think whether the pattern of questions which are being asked, whether you are able to understand the question itself or not. And if you do have economics background or any subject background, definitely you few of the concepts you will be able to recall by saying the questions. Try to bifurcate the questions. Keep in front of you 3 to 4 years question paper. Work on it for 2 to 3 days. Try to understand it, try to analyze it. Go through the websites if you are not able to understand a particular question. Meet the right person and then introspect yourself whether you are comfortable with the set of questions or not. So largely, whether you opt any subject, X, Y, Z, any subject, let's say, remember, take suggestions from the right person take suggestion from the person who knows that particular subject, take suggestions from the person who understands the technicalities of the subject, simply do not move here and there asking X and Y. If you do like this, remember, you will be dancing in and around one or two options for the next 6 months, which will leave you, which will only frustrate you, and after 6 months also, your queries, your dilemma, your confusions, your conflicts will not be resolved. So take time. Give time to a particular subject for 5 to 6 days. Don't be in a hurry. You have to read the subject very comprehensively. Your career lies on this particular subject. So, try to take suggestions from the right person who knows you, who understands you, who mentors you, and to whom you think can give you right suggestions. Here, most of the time I have found that students are on the verge of taking their prelims exams, but if I ask them whether you have read your syllabus and how many times, most of the times it happens that students have not explored the different topics which are mentioned in the syllabus. So forget reading books, forget reading magazines. The first part of reading should be reading the syllabus thoroughly, comprehensively, exploring each and every point. Next, different people will suggest you the books and magazines. No doubt, there are a number of books and magazines which are available. But here, see, there is no strategy which can be the best strategy as far as UPSC preparation is concerned. So reading books also, that you may find that successful students sharing the name of the books, name of the magazines, and you start blindly following it. Remember, what suits others at times may not suit you. In economics, there are different books available for microeconomics. There are different books available for macroeconomics. There are different books available for growth and development, international economics. But then you cannot say that one book is good and other one is not good. There are certain selected authors. They have contributed largely to a particular domain of economics. So you cannot question their contribution What matters to you is that if you are reading XYZ book of microeconomics, and if ABC also is a good book, so there is no any fixed guideline that you should only follow XYZ and you cannot follow ABC. If you are not comfortable with the language of XYZ, don't go simply following that book, considering someone has suggested to you. You can still follow ABC and you can be successful. Remember, languages also matters in understanding concept of economics. So take help of your teachers. It's not hard and fast that if someone has read MANQ, all students should only go for MANQ. They cannot go for Froen and other books. It's not that other books available in the market which covers the syllabus of UPSC are not good. There are few books from each domain of economics which are really good and the authors are well renowned. So, in selection of books, dear students, what you need to do for each specific domain, let's say microeconomics, let's say macroeconomics, let's say public finance, initially you take up one book from each domain which have been suggested to you by your teacher, by your seniors, by your mentors, and try to find it out that whether that subject covers the overall syllabus of UPSC or not, and if it covers, whether the language you are able to understand or not. And if you are fine with it, go for it. I always suggest students, don't go after a number of books that you have to read. Go for the quality of the book, content of the book, and that's what matters in economics. So, as far as selection of the books is concerned, there is no hard and fast that if somebody has followed XYZ, you should always follow. There are different alternatives. There are very, very good books in economics available in the market by well-renowned authors, those who have reputations in the world. So, those books are equally good. The only thing will determine is that whether that book covers the overall syllabus or not, and whether you are comfortable with the language, the style of writing of that book or not. Number of hours as far as reading is concerned does not matter. Maine 12 ghante padhe, wo 14 hours padhta tha. Trust me, number of hours does not matter. Each one of you has certain unique strengths, your capabilities, the level of understanding altogether differs. You are influenced by different environmental factors. So you cannot compare with others ki wo 8 ghanta ya 12 ghanta ya 16 ghante pad raha hai to aapko bhi 16 ghante padhna chahiye. UPSC is not all about number of hours. And economics as a subject is specifically, it does not care about how many hours you put in, your concentration, your consistency will determine the success rate rather than the number of hours which you have contributed. So try to balance try to have a balanced approach which can keep your body and mind fit, which can help you to be consistent throughout preparation. It does not matter whether you study in the day, study during night. What matters is whether those hours which you have contributed, whether and to what extent you have absorbed, and that will only determine the success rate. So don't copy, don't compare yourself with others. You are unique in yourself. If you do have good analytical ability, there are few students, they can recall a particular event for a longer period of time. Now, do you know why we are able to recall? We are able to recall because we are totally absorbed in that particular event. We enjoy that particular event. Aap mujhe bataiye ki a beautiful song which we used to enjoy in our childhood, we remember it during our old age also, but certain concept of mathematics, certain concepts of physics, certain concept of a particular subject which we were taught during our childhood, we forget old age. In the mid of the age, we forget. Aur hum bolte hain yaar bahut din ho gaya padha hua. अरे आपने जो बचपन में गाना सुना था वो भी तो बहुत पुराना हो गया. Why you are able to recall that particular song? Why you are able to remember that particular song and not economic concepts? It's only because that you enjoy that particular song very much. It's only because that you are totally absorbed in that particular song very much. Each and every lyrics of that particular song, you enjoy it, and that was not with a particular subject, that's why you forget. So we need to understand it, that when you are reading something, most of you have a habit that you will be listening to a song and you will be reading economic concepts also. My dear students, I can tell you all, you will remember the song, you can never remember the economic concept. So don't use that way, unique way of reading style also, don't develop, don't follow. And that's what I told you all. It does not matter how many number of hours you put in. What matters is what you have read, what you have absorbed. Unless and until you are deeply absorbed, unless and until you enjoy that particular subject, you will not be able to recall, you will not be able to remember for a longer period of time. Reading only will not help you in any subject. Forget economics. Simply reading will not do. If you want to be absorbed in a particular subject, you need to develop love and lust. No subject is difficult. It altogether depends upon what efforts you are putting in, how much time you are devoting to it. At this age of yours, in order to win others, आप बताइए कि बहुत बार at this age you devote 3 years of your graduation after a particular boy or after a particular girl in order to win him or her. Now tell me, when you desire for UPSC, when you desire to attain your dream, why you cannot before that time in order to understand that particular subject? I again tell you an example that when you meet your loved ones, आप उनके साथ इतना एब्जॉर्ब हो जाते हो, यू फील दैट वॉज योर बेस्ट टाइम, प्रेशियस टाइम, यू आर टोटली एब्जॉर्ब एंड यू डिड नॉट, आफ्टर सर्टेन पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम यू फाइंड इट आउट, यार 2 घंटे हो गए, 4 घंटे हो गए, पता भी नहीं चला. नाउ व्हाई दिस हैज हैपेंड? दिस हैज सिंपली हैपेंड दैट यू हैव एंजॉयड ईच एंड एवरी मोमेंट ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर टाइम विथ हिम और हर, with that individual to whom you have love and respect. Why this cannot happen with a particular subject? And this can only happen when you work for it, when you give time to it, when you put in your best efforts. And trust me, you must have experienced also in your childhood age ki aapko maths bahut acha lagta hai, तो आपको हमेशा मन करता है कि आप मैथ्स के प्रॉब्लम ही सॉल्व करें, और इकोनॉमिक्स सबसे डिफिकल्ट लगता है तो आप उसको उसकी तरफ ध्यान भी नहीं देते. ऐसा क्यों हुआ? क्योंकि यू हैव वर्क फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट, और इकोनॉमिक्स इसलिए आपको अच्छा नहीं लगता है कि यू हैव नॉट वर्क फॉर इट, यू हैव नॉट पुट इन योर एफर्ट्स. मैथमेटिक्स आपको ऐसे ही अच्छा नहीं लगने लगा. You have given your precious time to it. So, concluding, I want to tell you ki simply reading will not do. You need to have consistency. Don't compare with others. Don't compare with how many hours your friends are putting in. Compare yourself with only you, your activities yesterday, your activities today, your plan of actions tomorrow. You compare with this, you compare with yourself that what was your basis of preparation 6 months back, what is it right now? Whether you have overcome your weaknesses or not. So try to introspect on these particular points rather than comparing yourself with your friends. Remember, you all of you do have unique attributes, and that only makes you unique identities, unique individuals. Understanding economic subject requires a lot of thinking, deep thinking it requires. If you are reading certain paragraph of a particular book on microeconomics or macroeconomics, you need to give time wherein you can think about that particular paragraph, correlate with different variables which you have come across while reading that particular paragraph. Read between the lines. Read the last line of the chapter with the first line of the chapter when you started. And when you are not able to correlate, when you are not able to relate the last line of the chapter with the first line, it means you have taken a half-hearted effort. So for each and every chapters, you need to give maximum time to critical thinking. At times, in economics, when you will be thinking critically, you will be confused also. But then remember, in economics, when you are confused, you are on the right track. When you are getting confused, at least one thing is certain, that you have started thinking about it. And when you have directly absorbed, it means you have not given a thought to it. So simply reading will not do in economics. Your reading should be backed by critical thinking. Your reading should be backed by correlating this paragraph with the last paragraph, sorry, with the previous paragraph, the last line of the chapter with the first line of the chapter, and then only you can justify that whether you are able to understand a particular chapter or a particular topic or not. So, remember one thing, reading will not do, simply reading will not do. Most of the time students come to me, ki sir, humne XYZ book pad liya, ab kya kya, ab dusra book kaun padhe? To main unse ek question puchta hoon, aur most of the time mera answer rehta hai, ki once again read the same book. And the reason is that, first of all, whatever the basic books have been suggested to you, the fundamentals which have been suggested to you, you need to have a strong foundations, you need to have a strong basics approach as far as understanding of that particular subject is concerned. It is not matter. And that you will be able to understand the whole topics of a particular subject in the first reading. Aap agar dusri baar aur tisri baar us particular book ko padhte ho, to you will be able to analyze that many of the concepts which you are not able to understand in the first reading, you are able to understand only in the second and third reading. Many of the correlation with the variables, you are not able to justify, you are not able to do in the first reading, that you are only able to do in the third reading. And that's what is required. The next part is that most of the students, those who have economics background, पता नहीं उनको क्या लगने लगता है कि वो 30 मार्क कान हो गए हैं. एंड व्हेन दे ऑप्ट इकोनॉमिक्स एज एन ऑप्शनल, दे डू नॉट थिंक इट इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर देम टू गो थ्रू द बेसिक बुक्स बीइंग सजेस्टेड. Remember this. Don't make this blunder. You are not a superman. You are not a superhero. You are not. Adam Smith. You are not Karl Marx. You have to be. And when you want to be, you have to start with a strong foundation. And to have a strong foundation, even if you know that you understand the basics, once you will be going, once again when you will be going through basics, take my words, you will be getting additional information which you will be getting additional inputs, additional insights which you have not thought before. So even though you do have background of a particular subject, when you are preparing for a subject, first of all, go through the basics. Read between the lines. Read it thoroughly. Read it carefully. Try to correlate. And then I'll tell you, you'll have no doubt a strong foundations. Now, revision. Remember, it's revision. Without vision, there will never be revision. तो आप बताइए कि कोई बच्चा क्या करता है कि एक बार उसने बुक्स को ऐसे पढ़ा कि he is not able to recall कि उसने क्या पढ़ा. And then when he is going for the second time, because he is not able to recall, he is saying, he is facing a problem. कि सर ही इज डूइंग रिविजन. मन को उसको बहुत खुशी होती है, बट देन द आउटकम इज नॉट पॉजिटिव. क्यों? बिकॉज देयर वर नो विजन टू इट. उसने पहला जो विजन करना चाहिए था उस पर्टिकुलर चैप्टर का, वही उसने अच्छा से नहीं किया. ही हैज नॉट डन इट ऑन ए कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव नोट. So that's why I'm telling you ki whenever you are doing it, when you are reading for the first time, give time to it. Don't be in a hurry. It's better to give time. Now than in future. So give time to each and every chapter of your subject. Every chapter of that particular book, in order to have deep insights of that, about that particular subject. And unless and until you develop deep insights of a particular subject, you cannot develop vision, you cannot think about that particular topics, considering the broader dimensions, multi-dimensions of that particular subject. And when, and unless and until you have developed this, there cannot be revision. So pehli baar jab aap padhte hain kitab ko, aap is tarah se padhe ki theek hai, time lag raha hai, that's fine, don't worry about it. But then pehli baar padh rahe hain, usme hi aap itna efforts put up kare ki you develop insights. You have broader understanding about that particular subject. You develop different dimensions of that particular subject, and that's what will help you in having a clear-cut vision about that particular subject. And when it is done, then when you will be going for the next time, then only that will be considered to be revision. And the next one is quality study material. Again, I am telling you, don't follow the road models. Aap Delhi mein jaoge, so besides roads, there'll be many hawkers selling study materials, jahan par you will also be confused ki kya padhe kya nahi padhe. So my advice to you is that try to distinguish between road models and role models. I'm again repeating, as far as study material is concerned, try to distinguish between road models and role models. And when you are able to do so, you are able to get real insights about this particular subject, which will help you, definitely help you in preparation. So kisi bhi subject ke jahan tak study material ki baat hai, aapko bahut jyada study material available milenge, but then aapko ye decide karna hai ki kya aapke liye road model hai aur kya aapke liye role model hai. Now next we'll be discussing about how we can understand, analyze and interpret this particular subject. See, I also accept this particular fact that compared with other subject, this subject is considered to be slightly difficult. I mean, if you ask me that for me, this subject may not be difficult. If you ask me about history, if you ask me about geography, if you ask me about any other subject, for me, that may be difficult. But since I am with the subject for the last so many years, neither then it was difficult to me, nor today it is difficult to me, the definition of difficulty will differ from a person to person. If you have interest in something, you will not find any difficulty. But you do not have any interest in that particular subject, that subject will definitely be difficult to you. But even though this subject is considered to be difficult, this subject can be made very, very simple when we start applying economic principles, when we start applying economic theories in day-to-day walk of life. Apply each and every economic theory, economic principles in your day-to-day life, and simple decisions, simple economic activities, when you will start exploring that, you will find that somewhere or other this activity is related to economics. I always consider that on day-to-day basis, each and every day, you take so many economic decisions. The only thing is that till today you have not realized about it, that those are based on economic principles. Once you realize, then you will come to know that this subject and its principles are being applied, being followed by you every time and everywhere. I want to have dinner in a restaurant . I want to join Unique Academy. I want to attend demo lecture. I want to buy X and Y and not A and B. All these are depend upon economic decisions. But we have never realized the different challenges being faced by the society today and the nation today, the solutions to those challenges being faced by the society and the nation lie in economic principles. Why the farmers are committing suicide? Why Indian educated youths are unemployed? What are the reasons behind hunger and starvation? What is the reasons behind Naxal and extreme groups? What are the reasons behind poor health infrastructure? If you try to find it out, the solutions, so you may find the solutions are inherent in economic principles. So the need is that you need to apply the principles in day-to-day life, whether I should go buy a car, private car, or whether I should go for buy a public transport, whether I should go by train or whether I should go by flight. Your in near future, your marriage decisions also will be based on economics. Whether I should go for online lectures or offline lectures. This subject, no doubt, can be made simple. You need to come out with the jargons. Come out of it. Economics is not only all about jargons. Economics is not only about complexity. Economics is all about a poor. Economics is all about a farmer. Economics is all about a farm. Economics is all about you. Economics is all about me. So when economics involves each and everyone, why it cannot be made simple and why it cannot be made interesting? The subject cannot be mugged up. You may not enjoy this particular subject by mugging up. You need to completely bring clarity with the concepts. You need to come out with different set of informations which are available with and then once you have simplified the concept, you have understood the concept, you do have the data or set of informations with you, then you will be able to analyze, you will be able to interpret, in the last few days, you must have heard that India's GDP is contracting. Contemporary issue, current issue. Now, as an economic student, you need to understand that what do you mean by contraction in GDP? If you do have understanding about it, the second question which comes to you, that there is nothing new in it. Why there is nothing new in it? Because since economic activities, either in agriculture or in industry or in services, are not normal, so definitely the impact of this will be felt on growth numbers. And we all know that in this pandemic, except agriculture, except farm, except rural economy, the industries are struggling, the service sector is struggling. So, when economic activities are not taking place, we cannot expect that GDP will expand or economic activities will expand. So, these contemporary issue, this current issue, you need to analyze, interpret. And what can be the interpretations? That what can be the consequence of this contraction? How it will impact employment or unemployment in the future? How it will impact the consumer and investment demand in the future? Whether it will be able to raise the confidence of investors and consumers in the market or not. So once you know GDP, you have understood the concept of GDP, you have understood the meaning of expansion and contraction in an economy. When you do have the facts with you, information with you, that economic activities are not taking place in Indian agriculture, industry and services. So on that basis, you can directly analyze and interpret that these are the regions which are responsible for contraction in economic activity and contraction in GDP. So there is nothing new to be surprised of. If the second thing, you must have heard, you must have read also that forex reserves of India is an all-time high level of $541 billion. Now we need to understand that what do you mean by foreign exchange reserves? What are the different components of foreign exchange reserves? What are the reasons behind huge inflow of foreign exchange reserves? Under such pandemic, when other economic variables are not performing well, why there is a huge inflow of foreign currency reserves in India? What will be the consequence? Whether rupee will appreciate or depreciate? If rupee will appreciate, what will be its consequence on the inflation in the country? So, I told you all simply, understanding concepts, having set of informations related to that particular concept will help you in better analysis, better interpretations, and that's what is required in economics. So those students who are from science background, those students who are from engineering background, those students who are from economics and commerce background and having interest in this particular subject can definitely think of, I'm not saying you should go for, can think of opting economics as an option. Now the last part of my discussion will focus upon notes and answers writing. See, in economics, notes, making notes is very, very important. Once you have understood the concept, your fundamentals regarding that particular subject are very clear, then you can go for making notes. But don't start making notes in the first reading itself, because in that case you will be writing down all the contents of the book and that cannot be considered to be note. तो पहले रीडिंग में आप पहले पढ़ने की कोशिश कीजिए, समझने की कोशिश कीजिए, एनालाइज एंड इंटरप्रिटेशन की कोशिश कीजिए, और जब सेकेंड रीडिंग आप उस पर्टिकुलर बुक की दे रहे हैं तो प्लीज राइट फ्यू पॉइंट्स अबाउट दैट पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक विच यू हैव अंडरस्टूड. राइट इन बुलेट पॉइंट्स. डोंट कंप्लीटली कॉपी the language which are there in the chapter, there in the book. Make notes in a very simple language which you have understood. Making short notes are very, very important, reason being that during examination that will help you in revising things in the shortest possible time. As far as answers writing are concerned, many students have a confusion that, sir, in economics we have to use data too much. No. Use of data is only required, is only necessary where it is required. And you will be taught that which data will be important for you and which will not. But no doubt in economics optional, in order to justify the facts, economics as a subject is not based on merely on opinions. If you do have certain opinion, you need to justify that by using numbers. And relevant data is important, not simply data. Koi bhi data aap use kare, so that will not justify. You need to use relevant data. Understanding question is very, very important. And the simple way to understand it by forgetting the question into different segments. In economics, we cannot make stories. We need to stick to what has been asked. This will save your time also, which you can devote to other questions. In economics, contemporary issues and current affairs related to business economics are very, very important. Why important? Because when you are justifying a particular theory, giving examples of current issues or current affairs, it means you are trying to show that you have understood the concept and you are playing with the concept, you are able to correlate that concept with day-to-day current affairs which have taken place. And the last one about is, as I told you, don't refer and follow friends' philosophy. Be with good persons. Be with good people who motivates you, who give you different positive insights. And one another point, last but not the least, I want to tell you that at the initial stage of writing answers, start with very, very simple questions without any word limit at the initial stage. After 1 or 2 months of writing, slowly, gradually, you start customizing yourself based on these questions, specific questions which had been asked. Because that will help you, that will motivate you, and you yourself will analyze that what is the demand, what is the requirement of a particular question, and what point you should write and what you should not write. And this will only come, as I always tell, that the base strategy to develop good writing skills is to practice more. But practice more ka ye matlab nahi hua ki aap likhte jayein without introspecting, without showing it to your mentors, without showing that answer to your teacher, seniors. Give it for evaluation to your teacher, to your senior. Take their feedback, try to incorporate those suggestions and see over a period of time when you will follow this activity. So definitely you, without any other external help, you will develop a good writing skill. In economics, if you are really want to score good marks, those who say that economics is not scoring, I think they are not well versed with the subject. Economics is no doubt scoring. It altogether depends upon what you write. The success rates of students opting economics optional, no doubt in the years has increased. And if you happen to see their ranking, you may find them in a very good ranks, holding good ranks. This only because of the fact that they have scored very good marks in optional. But then, the only precaution I am trying to tell you, that without understanding the concepts, without having clarity of the concept, you may not get good marks. You cannot bluff. So one thing I follow in economics, that whether you will be getting good marks or you will not be getting good marks, but definitely when you have clarity about the concept, there is no doubt that you will not be getting, you will not be scoring good marks in economics optional. So conceptual understanding is very, very important. So concluding, I want to tell you that read, but careful reading, reading between the lines, reading authentic material is very, very important. Understanding the concepts comes, understanding of concept will come from that. Once you will be reading carefully, definitely you will be able to understand the concepts. And conceptual understanding in economics will be the main criterion which will decide that whether by opting economic optional, you will be able to clear UPSC or not. So there will be larger thrust on conceptual understanding. Once you are clear with this, you will not face any problem. Overall, about this subject, I want to tell you all the myths regarding all the myths regarding this subject, that economics is difficult, economics is not scoring, economics is only for those who have economics background. It's nothing like that. The myths are not reality. In the recent years, you can get a lot of examples where students from different streams have also opted economics optional and they are successful. But then opting any optional subject, taking decisions of opting any optional subject will be based on upon whether you do have interest in that particular subject or not, whether you do have economics background or not, whether you can get good study material and good guidance from experts or not. That's what will determine. But it's not about a particular subject. Generally, my sincere request to all the students who are preparing for UPSC is that don't follow friend's philosophy. Go to the right person to take suggestions, who knows you, who understands you, who knows your strengths and weaknesses. Definitely, if you will take guidance from them, they will help you. They will tell you the right path. But then don't go to a person and ask him about an optional wherein that person does not have any expertise. So based on this, you take decision, take time to it, give time to it. Don't be in a haste. Follow each and everything what I have told you regarding selection of optional subject. Your career depends upon it. So take a judicious decision. It doesn't matter that you are taking 5 to 10 days. What matters is that once you have taken the right decisions, you stick to it, considering that this is the best which you can take, and with your hard work, this will drive you to the path of success. Thank you so much. Any question, most welcome.
Dhirendra sir, there is no questions at all.
Okay, shall I end?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you so much. Thank you to you all.